Hey, can everybody, whoa, that mic is very hot. Okay. Well, good evening, everyone. My name is Jim Nova, and I am the second trombone player in the Pittsburgh Symphony, but I am also known as the utility player of the Pittsburgh Symphony, which basically means that I'm sort of the Mr. Fix-It of my section. So I'll play alto, tenor, bass, and contrabass all, you know, within the course of the season. And some of you may be sort of thinking there, saying, why would you play movie music on trombone? Like, how did that happen? Well, when I was a student, my teacher in my undergrad, I went to the Curtis Institute of Music in Philadelphia. My teacher was Glenn Dodson, who's the principal trombonist of the Philadelphia Orchestra. And he would often have his students come over and the Philadelphia Orchestra section come over, and we would have these little hangs that we called bone bashes, where we'd like play all these crazy arrangements. And that's where the seed got planted for me to start doing these kinds of arrangements. And so about 10 years ago, I started going through these arrangements that I had done, started recording all the parts myself. And that kind of put them out into the world. And so all of a sudden, all these like college professors started calling me and saying, hey, could you come and do a concert with us? And we'd love to play your music. And the recordings I made, I put them on this website called SoundCloud. SoundCloud is kind of like YouTube for music. You know, I think a lot of the young people in the audience probably know what I'm talking about. But for those of you out there my age or older, now you know. So I've been to 82 schools as of today in 9 years. And my SoundCloud has hit 1.6 million listens. So it's kind of shocking to me that, you know, people would be so drawn to this stuff. But as you can hear, it almost doesn't matter what instruments you play it on. If you play great music, it sounds terrific. And I just also want to thank Dr. McCain for having me back. I was here 4 years ago. in 2018, and it's really terrific to be back. The next selection we're going to play for you tonight is the main title from Beetlejuice. Who here has seen Beetlejuice? Okay. So, anybody want to take a guess how many minutes Michael Keaton is actually in Beetlejuice? Anybody brave enough to take a guess? No one? Now, we can all agree he's the title character, right? He's the main character. He's in the movie for 17 minutes. It's kind of crazy, right? I mean, I guess, like I say, there's no small parts, only small actors. So this is the main title to Beetlejuice by Danny Elfman. I hope you enjoy. Okay, how many NFL fans we got out there? Yeah. Okay, one very, very enthusiastic one, right? Yeah. During the worst of the pandemic, when we were locked down, I remember sort of thinking about doing a new arrangement, and I don't know how I never knew this, but the NBC football theme that I've known for ages, like. It turns out it was written by John Williams. And so from here on out, we're going to be only playing John Williams for the rest of this concert. And we're going to be playing the NBC football theme next. It's called Wide Receiver. And, Dr. McCain and I are both, yeah, there we go. Okay. We're all NFL fans here. That's right. Uh-oh. We share this love of football, and during the pandemic, I did this arrangement, and I put together this virtual recording of players from all these different orchestras, who turned out to be all, fans of different teams and stuff, and, I've got to go grab my jersey, so I will be right back.
Now I'm from Pittsburgh, so of course. But what do you think of that?
So now our we're gonna move into the next arrangement. That's called I call this a gathering of villains. I mean, doesn't it seem to me that the bad guys always have the best tunes? It just seems like they always get written the best music. And so I was like kind of listening to a bunch of different bad guy tunes and John Williams, and I was thinking, oh, if I move this around here, I can make this little suite of bad guy tunes. I call it a gathering of villains. And some of them are going to be obscure to you. So I want you to think about how many different bad guy themes you hear in this arrangement, and if you recognize any. Some of them I hope are pretty obvious, but these first couple ones you might be scratching your head thinking, wait, I know that. Where is it from? What movie is it from? You know. But I hope you enjoy this. It's the Gathering of Villains by John Wayne.
Yeah.
Anybody want to take a guess how many there were in there? How many bad guy melodies? How many were there? Four? We got a guess of four. Okay, how many others? Any other guesses?
Five.
Yeah, I think the gentleman right there, he's got seven up. There were seven bad guy melodies. Anybody know what the first one was? That's the most obscure one. Yeah, that's right. Okay, what was the second one? Yes. Then after that, it gets kind of easier, right? What was the third one? It was the Emperor's theme. And then after that, any guesses? Kylo Ren, that's right. Okay. Then after Kylo Ren was Jaws. Did you like the sound effects we did? Yeah. You like that? We got to be creative, you know? And then, of course, the last one is, that's right. He's got the best bad guy melody. That's why we're actually going to play it twice in this concert. We're going to play the full version later. And can we agree that there is nothing more sinister than a contrabass trombone? Right? I mean, look at that thing. It's like, keep your children safe from that, you know? It's like, look at that thing, you know? It's like it drinks the souls of the damned or something, you know? And Martin plays the heck out of it, doesn't he? You know. So. Okay, so we're going to end our first half. We're going to just take a short 10-minute intermission, and then we're going to go all Star Wars all the time for the second half. So, yeah, that's right. I'm with you. So this last piece we're going to play is the Planet Krypton Fanfare and Superman March from the original Superman film. And I just love this moment in the film. This is like this opening scene is like as you're approaching the planet, the Krypton, and it, you know, I just remember being a little kid watching this and just being like, man, I want to play that music. I want to play that music. So I hope you enjoy this, and I please hope you'll stick around for the second half, because all, you know, we'll be playing a bunch of cool Star Wars charts. So hope you enjoy this.
Thank you. I
So it's against certain zoning codes to have a movie concert without Star Wars music on it. So that's why this whole second half is going to be dedicated to Star Wars. That first selection was, of course, the iconic main title, followed by the flag parade, which is from Episode One. And you know, I'm sure that most people maybe don't remember that music because those movies. But I think we can all agree that the music is the through line through all nine of these fabulous films. Like John Williams just such an incredible way of capturing the adventure and the drama of these movies. And for me, the music tells the story better than the movies do in a lot of ways. Anytime I hear this stuff, I'm transported immediately. And so this next selection we're gonna play for you is Yoda's theme. And I remember seeing the Empire Strikes Back in the theater when I was a little kid. More on that later. But this Yoda's theme, whenever I play this, I always think about the fact that now, at this point in my career, I am much more concerned about the choices I make with my students, and guiding them and helping them move forward, than I am about my own performance anymore. I feel like I've got that part of my career figured out. And I think about my students and the struggles they're going through, and even some of the wonderful students I got to work with today. As a matter of fact, I got to work with my grand student over here. This guy studied in high school with my former student who teaches in the Austin area. My hip suddenly hurts, but it's just been a real joy to explore that part of my career. And I just want to share with you a fun story about the first time I met Norman Bolter. Norman Bolter was the second trombone player in the Boston Symphony for many years. He was my teacher in graduate school. And I studied with him when he was younger than I am now. And, I remember the first time I met him, back then we didn't have supercomputers in our pockets that we could look up anybody's picture or whatever. I just heard of him. And I thought I'd call him and have a lesson with him. And sure, meet me at Symphony Hall in Boston on this date, this time. And I show up and I'd heard all these recordings of him. And I get this picture in my mind of what he must look like, right? And I show up at the stage door of Symphony Hall, and I look down the staircase from the street level down to where you go backstage. And he comes around the corner and he says, "Jim?" And I look down and I was like, "Yeah." And he goes, "You thought I'd be bigger, didn't you?" And because he's 5'5", he weighs maybe 155 pounds, and he buys his shoes in the boys' section of stores. So he is a small man. And the way he plays the trombone, though, let's just put it this way. The Superman march you just heard, the first time I ever played as an extra with the Boston Pops, I played with him, and he buried me. At the big, loud spots, I just couldn't even keep up with him. And that's how our sort of friendship and teacher-student relationship started. And he's still a very good friend, and we communicate often. And I just want to dedicate Yoda's theme. Everybody all his students refer to him as the Yoda of the trombone, given his small stature and immense playing ability. So I want to dedicate this to Yoda, but also I want to dedicate it to all the teachers out there who educate our young people. And trust me, they take their jobs very seriously. Okay, hope you enjoy. Okay, so the next selection we're going to play for you is from The Revenge of the Sith, which is episode 3, which, of those three prequels, I think is probably the strongest film. And what I love about John Williams is that he writes these incredible portrait pieces, Yoda's theme, and then we'll play Imperial March later on. But this one, Battle of the Heroes, I love how he plays with the title of, it's like the two heroes fighting each other. And so, given what we know, I think I can say spoiler alert at this point, like if you haven't seen the original Star Wars, what are you doing here? So in the original Star Wars film, of course, it's revealed that they had a battle long ago. So you know at some point it's going to happen, and you're like figuring out how they're going to write themselves out of this, And this moment in the film is when they're battling each other. And, it's incredible complexity of this music, but it's so universally you can connect to it universally. And we can agree that this scene would be nothing without this music. This scene would just be kind of silly without it. Do yourself a favor when you get when you get on YouTube at some point, look up the throne room, which we're gonna play at the end of this concert. Look up, there's a version of the throne room that doesn't have music. It's the strangest thing you've ever seen. It's like, you hear the sound effects and you hear like people like beat and everything, but you hear no music and you're like, oh. But if you hear the music, you can instantly see the scene. So this is Battle of the Heroes from Revenge of the Sith.
Thank you.
Okay, so we've finally gotten there. The best bad guy melody ever written. Right? The Imperial March. Yeah, some people not that. Exactly. I remember I said put a pin in it. Okay, we're taking the pin out. Okay, so when I was six, I went to see this movie, The Empire Strikes Back, in the theater with my older brother and my dad. And I have this extreme vivid memory of leaving the theater, like practically in tears, saying, can't be his father. Like this little kid that just ruined me. You know, my brother's like, shut up, kid, come on, let's go. And you know, if you fast forward from there, you know, 3 years later, it's time for me to pick an instrument. Of course I wanted to pick an instrument from the brass family, you know, because my parents took me to see all these incredible John Williams movies. I remember riding my bike to watch the Return of the Jedi like 50 times, you know, E.T. and all that kind of stuff. And so naturally I wanted to pick a brass instrument. But you know, one of my favorite things about The Empire Strikes Back, you remember that scene in the when Han Solo is being lowered into the carbonite and Leia says, I love you, and he says, I know. Do you know that was improvised? Isn't that cool? I just think that's so neat. Because like apparently he was supposed to say I love you back, and Irvin Kershner, the director, was like, man, Han Solo wouldn't do that. Like, all right. Harrison, come up with something else. And then they just said, roll. And that's what he came up with. And now it's like, I mean, that line is so iconic that, like, I'm the world's easiest person to buy for my birthday and for Christmas, because you just, like, go to a Star Wars site and just say, add to cart, all this stuff, you know. And I actually have a set of aprons that my wife bought me that says, one says, I love you, and the other says, I know. So. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed the Imperial, well, I don't know, enjoy, is enjoy the right word? I hope you experience the Imperial March. We'll be right back. Well, we've come to the end of our concert. I want to thank everybody for coming out to check out the trombones at the movies. Funny thing I found out in April, John Williams came and conducted the Pittsburgh Symphony. He's been there many times and played with them in various orchestras and stuff. And I went backstage and talked to him about, he didn't know that I had made this entire Star Wars album of overdubbed arrangements, like the arrangements that we're playing tonight, except I played all the parts. And I said, John, can you settle an argument for me? There's a rumor out there that you were a trombone player when you were young. And he says, yeah, I was. I wasn't very good, but I did play trombone. And I was like, yeah, I bet you were pretty good. And he really loved that I'd done this project, and I gave him a score and everything. And he congratulated me. I was like, what? No. Thank you to you for all the incredible music. So it's really a joy for me to do these concerts, like I said, 82 times. So it's lovely to introduce this music, some of which these kids don't know, in this setting. And it kind of puts things in perspective a little bit. As a matter of fact, that grand student I mentioned today, we had a lesson, he was talking about how, he says, yeah, I need to work on my multiple timing, or my multiple timing is really struggling, and then they put Imperial March in front of me, and now it's like, oh my, it's still not great, but it's better, and I love that. That makes my heart warm to hear that, because, there's been plenty of schools that I've gone to where the kids are like, this is the hardest concert I've ever played, but the most fun, and that's really all I could ask for and hope for. I really want to give a special thanks to the S.E. Shires Company, because they make the instruments that I play, and a lot of us play on in the group here, and they help support my trip here. I want to thank Texas State for having me for the second time. What do you say? In 4 years, I'll be back? What do you think? Yeah? All right? Okay. I want to thank Dr. Jacob Harrison for conducting, Turns out he's a trombone player. He's not monophone. I mean, just dust it off every now and again and play. Semi-retired, right? Right. He's in the injured reserve, or no? and of course, I want to give a big thanks to my friend Dr. Martin McCain. You know, we've been friends for years, and love working with him and seeing him at festivals. And, you know, when he we saw each other at the International Trombone Festival this summer, and afterwards he contacted me and said, "Hey, you know, it's been 4 years. Let's have you back." And it was like, it wasn't even a question of yes. It was just when. When can we do it? So it's a real joy for me. And can you give a big round of applause to these kids for working on this program? It's such hard music. I mean, I quite literally know every note in all of these arrangements because I've played them all. So I know how hard they are. So to finish the concert, we're going to play the Throne Room from the original Star Wars movie.
Thank you.